The Metaltech rear swing-out bumper for the Lexus GX470 is the perfect overlanding bumper, designed to carry larger spare, extra fuel, as well as your high-lift jack. This kit comes with everything you need. It requires no welding or cutting on your truck. So let's get started with the installation of the bumper right now. Let's start out with by attaching any of the extras you may have ordered with your bumper to its shell. This includes rear lights, power takeouts, as well as side marker lights. While these are extras, the bumper is set up to accept them and simply allows you to screw them in and then run any wires you need for your harnesses in order to hook them up to your electrical system later. When you're running your wires, don't forget to establish a good ground to your bumper. That'll avoid problems down the road. The swing arm glides on bearings and is sealed to protect it from the elements. We'll want to make sure we get lots of grease in there, and then get our bearing for the lower section put into place. Let's also make sure we pack our upper bearing with plenty of grease and drop it into place for now. At this point, let's attach our pivot lock, and then we'll pre-assemble our door latch and attach it to the swing arm. Moving over to the shell bumper, attach the landing pad and the latch assembly. Let's move over to the other side and attach the glide plate. The final bit of pre-assembly, attaching our strut to the bumper shell. Now it's time to remove some of the plastic from the truck. Let's start by removing the bolt that holds the safety latch in place, and then the cover that sits atop the bumper. There are four bolts that are now visible, and we'll need to get those out of the way. On the driver's side, there's a little plastic snap we'll need to get out. Underneath, four more bolts hold the plastic bumper in place. Don't forget the plastic snaps where the rear bumper meets the mud flaps. And then we'll want to make sure we remove the screws that are holding the mud flap in the interior side. And finally, a couple of bolts that hold the rear bumper in place in the back of the wheel well. Now just give a little pull on each side and the bumper should release and slide right off. We still need to remove a couple more plastic retainers, but we want to hang on to the ventilator. We'll be reusing that. Time to grab a friend. The bumper can slide right into place. Be careful not to scratch any of the paint. It'll rest right on the frame. Your kit comes with two sets of spacers, one for above the frame and one for the bottom side of the frame. Two bolts on each side go directly into the frame, the spacer plate, and then two long bolts that'll snug everything tight. Once you have all your bolts in place, be sure to go back around and make sure that everything is torqued down good and tight. If you purchased the extra trailer hitch, now's a good time to bolt it into place. Let's drop the swing arm on top of the pivot. You may need to give it a wiggle or two to have the bearings sit right. Tighten the nut, and then we're just going to tighten up the nut enough to keep everything snug. We'll come back and finish it off later. Adjust the latch so that when it closes, it holds the swing arm tightly against the landing pads. Once you have the strut attached to the swing arm, tighten the nut down that holds the swing arm in place. Drop your cotter pin in and lock it off, and then put the dome cap on to keep the dust and dirt out. With the swing arm complete, we can now attach the optional fuel can carriers. Be sure to have the bolts on the inside with the nuts out so that you clear the door. In order to have your spare tires sit just right, take a measurement of the backspace and then transfer that over to the carrier. Once you have it set, tighten down everything and your spare tire should bolt snugly against the swing arm, keeping it from rattling around. Of course, carefully check clearance. You may need to make a slight adjustment or two. With the original cover in place, let's drill from below two small pilot holes through the existing threaded holes in the two steel brackets. This will locate the position for the bolts that we'll use to hold the plate in place. Next, drill the holes out from above with a 3/16 inch bit. Put the small white spacer in place, and using the included 6mm bolt and washers, attach everything. With your Metaltech rear swing-out bumper in place, your GX470 is all set for your next overland adventure.